Hi everyone, it's Holly. I am officially one day post-op from my hip arthroscopy surgery on my right leg. It went better than expected, and I'm just here to talk a little bit about the process and then how I'm feeling day one post-op. So yesterday morning, May 13th, I went in. My check-in was at 5:15 a.m. So super early, which was nice. Went in. I actually had to go in alone. My mom wasn't allowed or nobody with me due to COVID-19. I had to be in a mask the entire time I was there, which was interesting. So got all gowned up. Had my nurse come in and get me all checked in. Just weight, blood pressure, that kind of thing. She started the IV in my arm. After that, the anesthesia team came in. I actually got a choice between full anesthesia or spinal anesthesia. They recommended the spinal anesthesia, actually. So I went with that. So they explained that to me, just a really fine needle to get to the spinal fluid. So basically, kind of like an epidural, but not really, he said. So numbing me basically from the belly button down. That was right before surgery, but they also used some drugs into the IV. So I actually, no, I'm not sure if I was awake or not, if I was sleeping, but I don't remember any of it. So instead of like a full anesthesia when you're, kind of 0 to 100, you're awake, you're awake, you're awake, and then all of a sudden you're out. It's more of a gradual thing. And that was it was similar to when I woke up. So at that point, they wheeled me into the OR, and that's kind of the last thing I remember was being, in the room with the bright, shiny lights. I remember making a comment about Grey's Anatomy. And then after that, I don't remember anything until recovery. So in recovery, like I said, with the spinal, it's really similar. It's, very gradual. So I woke up, both legs were completely numb. And then they gradually kind of came back to being able to feel them, which took probably, I don't know, probably 3 hours. And then, I don't know, I probably didn't have or feel any pain until that night, till last night when everything was worn off. So upon waking up, I was super hungry. They gave me crackers. I had a ton of water and juice and anything I wanted. I actually wasn't really that tired at all either with full anesthesia. I know you're like super loopy and out of it. With the spinal, I didn't notice that as much, so that was kind of nice. Just trying to think of everything else. At that point, then they wheeled me back to my room, and I was able to text my mom to come back to the hospital. So she actually met me there. We just basically had to hang out until I had feeling in my legs. I wasn't feeling any pain at this point. I was just shaking a lot. And they just gave me some drugs for that, just, coming off the anesthesia. And basically, they helped me learn how to crutch and stuff. I had to use the bathroom before I was able to leave just to make sure that things were functioning properly. So I went to the bathroom. They taught us how to use my cooler. I'll have a video at the end of this. So basically, my leg, there's this ice pack that's attached to a cooler that we fill water and ice in, so it cools my leg. So I had that on for 24 hours, and now it's just once an hour, or on an hour, off an hour. So I came home, I slept a little bit. It was very chill. I was a little bit nauseous last night. Didn't sleep that great. I guess I'll touch on some things that helped me on the first night, especially, as I'm only on day two. The pregnancy pillow that I bought, I mentioned in the last video, is an absolute must. I actually have it right next to me here. I slept on a recliner last night. Here, I'll flip the video around. Actually, I can't, but recliner there, it's covered with a sheet, was super nice. Instead of having to lay in the bed, because then it can, prop me up and down, which was awesome. What else? I guess just I felt super puffy. I think that's normal. My mom said it's normal just from the excess fluids. So if you're feeling, if you've just had the surgery and you're feeling puffy, I guess that's normal. I'm a bit itchy from the oxycodone. I've been taking that like every 3 hours. So, you know, a little bit dizzy, you know, just not feeling myself. I'm hopefully going to be weaning off that. I want to just start taking the Tylenol. They also have me taking a couple different medications for anti-regrowth in the bone because they shaved a lot of that off in there. And then, sorry, I wrote down some notes here just to make sure I hit everything. My hip flexor is super angry, so my right leg, the hip flexor, I can't even lift my leg. I actually have to have Michael or my mom like lift it for me. So that's been interesting. I have compression socks on both legs, and just right now they have me 20% weight bearing on that right foot. So basically, on my right foot where the surgery was. So basically no weight there. I haven't had too much of an appetite, just eating bland stuff. My mom got me a Sonic shake yesterday, which was amazing. And this morning I just had some scrambled eggs, and I plan on just sitting here and relaxing the rest of the day and sleeping a lot. One more thing actually I just thought of that is a must is this tray by the table. It's kind of been like a nightstand. Actually, of course, right now nothing's on it, but just keeping like things close to you because you're not gonna be able to walk. So like Kleenex, water, the remotes, your medications, anything and everything you might want. So anyways, you can keep watching to see a couple of the videos and day of, and I plan on keeping you updated as I go through this. My support system of Michael and my mom has been absolutely necessary. This is not something that you can have a surgery on and then, you know, just have somebody for 24 hours or a few hours and then they go home. You're definitely going to need constant care. At least, I mean, we'll see how many days that I'm really not able to move by myself. So anyways, thanks for watching. All right, so it's about 5:15 a.m. As you can see, I am alone. I'm here for surgery. I'm set up in my room. I got here and due to COVID-19, we are not recommended to have visitors with us. So we'll actually just call my mom once I'm done. As you can see, we all have to wear masks. I had to get my temperature taken again. Obviously, my COVID test came back negative, which is awesome. Came in, I'm gowned up and getting ready to go. I'll keep you updated as things move along. Losing friends and I'm chasing sleep. Everybody's worried about me. In 2D. Say I'm in 2D. Surgery prepping. Like 3 hours post-op. We're out here moving. Masks on. Only one. Animals.